Hi there, this is Borko from Plum Sale. Today, I'm excited to show you how to set up an interactive org chart in your Microsoft Teams. In this video, we will cover everything on how to install org chart, to add it to Microsoft Teams channel, configure it, and even how to customize it to fit your needs. So stick around to see how your org chart can look like with Plum Sale org chart. Let's dive in. The first step is to install Plum Sale org chart to Microsoft Teams. An easy way to do this with a few clicks is to go to Microsoft App Source and install it from there. Once you go to the Plum Sale org chart product page and register for a 30-day free trial, you will be redirected to the org chart download page. And I want to emphasize that during this trial period, you will be able to test all of the org chart features without any limitations. There is a link with the this offer in the description section. Let's get back to installing the org chart. In here, you can see Get from Microsoft Store button. Once you click on it, you will be redirected to Microsoft App Source. In here, click on Get It to begin the installation process. It is very important that you have admin privileges to be able to finish this process. In most cases, this part is done by SharePoint admins and possibly HR team collaboration. Next step is to click on Add to App Site button and select option Enable this app and add it to all sites and option Add to Teams. So the org chart gets added to all sites on your SharePoint tenant and to your Microsoft Teams as well. In case you get this message that the app requires permissions approval, you can ignore it for now and click OK. Permissions are only required if you are using Entra ID as your data source. And just like that, we have added org chart to our Microsoft Teams. It took us less than a couple of minutes. Let's now see how to add the org chart to your Microsoft Teams as a tab. Go to Microsoft Teams, select the channel where would you like to add the org chart, click on the plus sign to add a tab and search for Plum Sale org chart. Click on it and click Save. You will get an option to configure the org chart. You can choose from different data sources and different customization options. The configuration process can take anywhere from a few minutes to a few hours. This mainly depends on the level of customization you would like to apply to your new org chart. Let's now configure the org chart. To start the configuration process, click on the Configuration Wizard button. In the first tab, we get to choose a data sources where our employee list is stored. Options are SharePoint list, Entra ID or formerly Azure Active Directory, user profiles, and Excel or CSV. But before choosing your preferred data source, you can test Plum Sale org chart with the demo data to see if it fits your needs. Simply select SharePoint list as a data source, for list keep create new list, and just enter the list name and keep field demo data toggle turned on. Now click next a few times and then finish. Org chart will create a new list in the specified SharePoint site with all columns and demo data. This is just to give you an overview and better understanding of its look and feel so you can test it and see all the functionalities it offers. This is how the org chart demo data looks like, and this is the list org chart created for demo purposes. You can see all the columns it added, but you can add or remove columns as needed, and feel free to customize and add additional properties in boxes and templates to be visible. We can go back to configure the org chart with the SharePoint list as a data source. I have my SharePoint list with employees prepared, and you can see how my SharePoint list looks like and columns it has in it. As I mentioned moments earlier, you can add or remove columns as needed. Please note that I used single line of text columns for all of my columns in SharePoint list, just to keep it simple. And this list has a bit over 300 employees. Now we go back to the configuration wizard. For site URL, select the site where you created the employee list. And for list, select the list with employees from the drop-down menu. My list name is Plumsale Employees. Next part is very important, and it is field mapping. This is used by the org chart to build a structure, and it is crucial to select it properly. In my case, I used work emails or unique identifiers for each employee, but you can use any other unique identifier such as company's employee ID, SharePoint list ID, and similar. Here is how columns from my SharePoint list are mapped to Plumsale org chart. The employee ID will use the work email column, while the manager ID will pull data from the manager email column. The employee name comes directly from the employee's name column. Then the assistant ID will use the assistant email column to assign assistants to managers who have this information populated. And finally, the dotted line manager ID, it pulls data from the dotted line manager email column and adding dotted line managers for employees who have this field populated. In advanced settings, you have an option to turn on search only index columns and enable vacancies. It is necessary to turn on search only index columns for SharePoint list in case your list has more than 5,000 items. In this case, you will have to go back to SharePoint list settings, add indexes for each column you would like to use for search. In case you need to enable vacancies in your org chart, there is a link to the video in the description section on how to enable vacancies and set up vacancy server. Go ahead and check it out. And after a few minutes of setting up, my org chart with all employees is ready to be published with live data. I will click the next a few times and finish, and let's see how it looks like. Org chart compact view makes it easy to see the company's full structure and navigate through it with advanced search options. In the search tab, you can search by name, department, job title, project, country, city, or any other keywords. You can also change the layout if you prefer something different. Similarly, you can set it up even faster when using Entra ID or SharePoint user profiles as a data source. As you can see, for Entra ID, you will only need to specify assistant ID and dotted line manager ID if needed, of course, as the rest of the fields or chart will grab automatically from Entra ID. It is a similar case for SharePoint user profiles. But for Excel and CSV, as a data source, setup looks similar to SharePoint list setup. I will leave links to the videos with step-by-step instructions for each data source. Now let's go back to Configuration Wizard again to apply other customization features. Specify root employee and filtration condition is next. This feature is very handy if you're looking to create multiple org charts and publish them in different department channels and start each org chart with the head of the department. With Plumsale org chart, you can create an unlimited number of org charts for your SharePoint and Microsoft Teams and publish them as web parts in your SharePoint or as tabs in Microsoft Teams channels. For example, you can use start structure from an employee to start the hierarchy from a certain employee. I will start here with the department manager, and you can see that we have got Haley West as a root employee, and she is the head of the HR department. Now, if we want to include all HR employees in Australia only, you can simply go back to Configuration Wizard and in filtration conditions, add a new condition which matches these criteria. Country contains Australia, right? And now we will get only HR employees in Australia. The same would apply for a different country, for the United States, for example. And we get HR employees from the United States. This is an easy way to filter based on other conditions, for example, job title and similar. In the Design tab, you can apply the base skin from the skin drop-down menu. Then you can choose the layout type, levels to expand, and max column width. In box style rules, you can add conditional rules and customize boxes based on different conditions. For example, I would like to differentiate assistant boxes, and add a different look to them. So I will give the name to this rule and select box type is equal to assistant, and then customize it. Let's apply some different formatting for assistants. Click Save to apply changes. Further, I would like to customize boxes based on departments. I will select department contains finance in this example and select colors I want. You can even change the heading font style, size and weight, then box content font style, borders and box sizes as well. And I will repeat this for a few more departments just to make my org chart look nice. Fast forward and we have a nicely looking org chart with all departments marked in different colors just to be more recognizable. If I select a head of department, you can see that all subordinates are the same color. Now I can choose a different layout to make them more organized. Then I want the CEO position to look different and more visible. We look for a job title which contains CEO and apply some different formatting and customization. And this is the final look of my org chart. The next step is to customize what's displayed once the org chart is loaded, which is done through box template. Then what's visible once you click on a person's name, which is tooltip template. And finally, what's visible once you do a search in search results, and that's search template. Let's start with the box template first. You can add or remove fields based on your preferences, of course. For example, I will add the country field and we will see how it looks like in boxes displayed in the org chart. Next, I want to shuffle a bit the order of the fields displayed just to make my org chart more intuitive. This is done by simply dragging and dropping fields. We can do the same for the tooltip template. For example, once I click on a person, I can see their phone number. Let's assume that's their private phone number, and for privacy purposes, we would like to remove this phone number. Simply go to tooltip template and remove the phone number field just with one click and save the changes. Now we don't have the phone number anymore displayed in the tooltip template. We can do other examples like adding the countries to the tooltip template and similar. The process is the same for search template. If we want to add a project to be displayed in the search box, we can simply go back to search template and add project field in the search box. And once we search for something, for example, for a network engineer, we will see which network engineer works on a specific project. Like in this example, Microsoft 365 migration, and we can choose to contact him directly via Microsoft Teams. And this was all about customizing templates. And as you can see, your creativity is a limit. I'm sure you will have plenty of use cases for this one. Custom code tab is much more advanced and it's out of the scope for this video. General settings are self-explanatory and I will leave it to you to explore it. And once we reach finish, we can hit that finish button and publish our org chart. And this is the final look. You can see how we managed to go from a list of employees to a fully functional org chart with advanced search options and customizations, which is automatically updated once the changes are made in the data source in a very short period of time. And that's it for this tutorial. Be sure to check out org chart playlist to learn more and hit that like and subscribe button. See you in the next video.